Is that good? Merry Christmas. It's messy, so we're actually out of town. We are in Maryland with Michael's sister for Christmas. It's 2 days after Christmas now. I'm sitting on Timberlake's blow-up mattress because that's where the window is. I don't have my ring light or anything. So that's what we're working with. Also, before anyone points it out, I know that there's like a patch in my money piece. It's a whole other story. It's going to be fixed, but that's what we're working with for now. But yeah, it's time for what I got for Christmas, which I've done since 2018. And I know everybody says it. I'm going to say it again. I'm not bragging at all, okay? I just like these videos. I love seeing what other people got. I think it's so fun. They're my favorite videos to make. Like, I could not post all year, and then I just post this one random video every year because they're just really fun to do. I think it's fun, and I also like watching people's what they got for Christmas video, because like everyone gets gift cards for Christmas too. So like going like, oh well, maybe I want to use some Christmas money on that. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna jump right into it. I'm gonna try not to talk about every item for 5 minutes at a time because I do that a lot. If you hear the bed, it's because I'm on an air mattress. That's what we're working with. But let's just jump into it. Let's knock this out. Probably put a transition here. Here we go. This is my stocking. I got a clippy, but it's I call it clippies, a claw clip, whatever. It's really big. I have really thick hair, and I can never get all my hair in a clip. So Michael got me this in my stocking. Oh, and normally I have everything laid out pretty, but I can't. So let me start with my stocking. I also have this super cute cup. It's sparkly. It says like water goals, daily water goals, something. I'll put a picture right here. I've been drinking out, but I think I left it somewhere. He got me a guasha and jade roller, which I've been asking for, and I didn't think he got it. I kept sending it to him, and said he was like, quit sending me this, I already got it. So that was in my stocking. I'm really excited about that. I had a guasha and Timberlake dropped it and it shattered. I got this soap. I wish that y'all could smell this. It smells so good. Like, so good. Absolutely so good. Hold on. I can't tell if I'm recording. We're going to pause and come right back. Make sure that this is going. Okay, no, it was recording. It's just been a while. I couldn't remember what it looked like. Okay, so yeah, I got the yummy soap. It smells so good. I got this cute little headband. I've been loving the like chunkier headbands. Oh, see, that looks so cute. See, I think the white will look good with like winter or spring. So, trying so hard not to tuck my bangs behind my ears. Got a face mask. Remember like OG YouTubers? Maybe I should overly saturate this video. This bath bomb, this little heart smells so good. I hate that you can't smell things through a video, but it smells so nice. This little clippy, I think will be so cute for spring. It's a light blue color. Super cute. Sorry if you're vacuuming, I'm sure Timberlake probably spilled something. Oh, I didn't even get these out of my stocking. These earrings, those are really cute. That's really funny. I didn't know they were in there. They give me Emily in Paris vibes. When you see my everything I got, you're like, wow, everyone shopped Emily in Paris for Amy. And then this bath bomb smells so good. Did this. So this little makeup bag, and it has, this is from my sister-in-law, has Tarte glow powder, which I wanted to use this stuff today, but I was like, let me wait for the video. The Lights, Camera, Lashes mascara by Tarte, and their Maracuja juicy lip stuff, which I've heard is so good. I can't wait to use this. And then 2 Impress nails. Literally, if y'all know me, all I use is Impress and Red Aspen. Those are the 2 things I use for my nails. So she got me this burgundy color and the light pink color. And I just had snowman nails that fell off. So I'm gonna do burgundy for this week. It's still kind of holiday-esque. And then when those fall off, do the light pink. for like the new year. I think that would be cute. And then it came with this Tarte makeup bag, just so cute. And this is so funny, she didn't even know. I had this cup in a different color, y'all probably saw it in videos, and it broke. It fell out of the car and just straight up shattered. So I have this really pretty like tan nude color, and it comes with two straws. I love these things. This is a glass cup with a little silicone sleeve, and I love mine. The only reason it shattered is it fell out of the car onto like the cement. So I am so excited. She didn't even know about my other cup, and I literally have one in my Amazon cart. I was like, oh, I'm just gonna get another one. So glad I did not. Let's see what's on this side. Okay, got these cute little socks. They're fuzzy socks from Pink Lily. Oh, all my stuff is falling. It's okay. I'll just put it on the floor. Oh, and this sweater is like a green, dark green, almost looks black, little cardigan with the pockets. I can like dress it up or dress it down. It's super cute and cozy. These crew socks, they're wool. She has some and she said they're just super cozy and tight. I like a tight fitted sock, so I'm excited about those. And then I got a foot soak, not a foot soak, yeah, just a detox bath soak. So I'm excited about this. And then a bath bomb, which is like a fiber relief, so it helps with like pain and stuff. And then a deep sleep bath bomb. So I'm excited about those. These are from J. Bell's Bath Bombery, which she got me hooked on. I used to be a Lush girly, but I'm hooked on J. Bell's now. So I don't know where this is from. Heritage Scrubs & Co. I'm excited about this. Y'all know I need that. I got a Red Dress Boutique gift card. I'm so pumped about that. Michael got me this sweater. It has these little like shoulder cutouts. And then the sleeves are like that. Once again, very Emily in Paris. I think it's so cute. I love this color. Got some Calvin Klein jammies. I like it's like a bluish gray color. I think those are super cute. This scarf, y'all. Also, sorry, the back of my hair is messy. I saw an outfit on Instagram or Pinterest, something. I had everything to recreate the outfit except for a white scarf. And I told Michael, I was like, I need to get a white scarf. I was like, can we just look on Amazon or something? I was literally about to buy one. And Kayla had already got one for me. And it's like big, like almost like a blanket. So cozy, it's from Pink Lily. And it has a little bit of color mixed in there. I think it's so cute. I like, you know when like for spring, you're cold, but you wanna wear brighter colors. It's gonna be so good. It's just like an all the time. Also wish you could feel stuff through the camera because it's so soft. Oh, it feels so good. Also got this sweater from Pink Lily. All the Pink Lily stuff is so soft. It's this lavender and white sweater. Got little stripies. I haven't worn it yet, but it's so soft. It's so soft. Oh, I can't even. You can wear like a shirt or unbutton it and wear it like a cardigan. These pants I'm so excited for. So when I opened this stuff, it was like wrapped in like the plastic from shipping. This was not, and she was like, okay, so the reason that it's not wrapped is because in plastic is because she'd ordered herself a pair, and if she liked them, she was gonna get one for me. So this was when she got her, but she put them on and she had like tons of extra length puddling on the floor. So they are the perfect length for me, and they're like a flare pant, which that never happens for me. And I put them on like with my slippers, which I'll show you. Timmy got me slippers, and they're still like the perfect length with a little extra, and they're high-waisted. That never happens. I'm so excited to have pants long enough. Speaking of slippers, Timmy got me these bear paw slippers, which is really funny because she got Michael slippers too, so she was thinking practical. Sorry about the vacuum. Between a dog and a toddler, there's vacuuming going on all the time. You do this, but yeah, love my slippers. I'm wearing them. Michael got me these shoes. Everybody has them. I've been wanting them. So these ones are clear because they will go with anything. It's like a nude because the black doesn't go with everything. The colors don't go with everything. But these are so pretty. Let me take this out. I need to start going out places because these are cute. That could be a thumbnail. I think I have something else in my other hand. So, I don't know. That was probably lame. Okay. It's super cute. I love these. I did know about them before, but I also had to try them on because I needed a pair of heels to bring on our trip, and I wanted to bring those, but I had to make sure they fit first. So, funny story about this. I have a really big head, and Torrid has hats in a size largest, which is where I normally get my hats. They had a fuzzy bucket hat sold out. Then they had another one that was kind of like it. And we went to the mall, and I was like, honestly, Torrid has it. And they had it, but the large was actually too big. But it was okay. But it looked a little silly because it was just too big. I didn't know Michael had already bought this one from Hollister. And when I put the hat on, he told me it looked bad because he was just trying to figure out a way for me not to know he already bought one. And so then I left him all crying because I thought this hat that I really wanted looked terrible on me. But then he bought this one. He was worried that it wasn't going to like fit, which it doesn't go all the way down, but I think it goes down enough to like, I'm still trying, because like, I can wear it on the back of my head. I can't pull it down like this. Oh, wait. It fits. No way. Just a little snug. Keep my brain safe. It's like a helmet. This probably looks dumb right now. I gotta figure out how to style it, like where, how far to pull it down. It's from Hollister. This one, he had a friend order it so I wouldn't see it. Another thumbnail. Once again, Emily Bears. That's a look. If it looks dumb, don't tell me because I'll be sad again. Also, I've not been feeling good, so sorry for my low energy. I'm feeling better today. And then this, I did not think Michael was going to get it. Also, don't say it's ugly, because by itself it kind of does. But I saw the picture online when the model had the whole fit, and I had a fit, because it was so cute. And very Emily in Paris. I'm to the point where I want to have matching shoes to my purses. And also green is like my favorite color to wear. And as you can wear year round, like this also a spring green. So she had it on with like light wash denim and like a white button-up blouse and then this, and so I want to recreate that, and then also like with a white dress. I think it would be so cute. The little bag and the little shoes. Michael calls these pancake shoes because they're square, but he bought them. He must not think they're that ugly. So I think these are so cute. Wait, another thumbnail option. Yeah, so I'm obsessed. I love the green. Also, I sound really nasally, sorry. You know when you don't have a stuffy nose, but it's just like clogged? That happens a lot in the winter because the heat's on and dries me up. Make sure I'm not missing. Okay, and the last thing I think was my big present from Michael. He got me this beautiful Kate Spade bag, which I guess is a becoming tradition because if y'all watched the last year's video, I was backwards. If y'all watched last year's video, I got that black bag, Kate Spade bag. This year, I have a white one, and it also has like the strap that goes over. I have not switched everything over yet because we haven't gone anywhere. We've been at home the past, well, we've been here, like staying in, not going anywhere, and it's been so nice. I think we're gonna go out this afternoon to the park or something, but I haven't gone anywhere, so I haven't needed to, switch it over. But I'm so excited. It's such a nice size. It's not too big. It can be crossbody. It can be like this. So it's super cute. I love it. I'm obsessed. I'm extremely thankful. Timberlake got so much cute stuff. Oh, and Michael. But I'm not prepared for the amount of stuff Timberlake is getting because I counted it. She has 7 or 8 more Christmases to do because we've just done our Christmas and with his sister because we were here on Christmas morning. So she's got all the different grandparents to go through. Michael and I, our parents are both divorced, so it gives her extra grandparents, which is nice, the love. But and we came to Maryland, and then we're going straight to Wilmington from here, and then going Wilmington back to home. So we have a lot of stuff, and we're gone for like 2 weeks, Nobody break into my house. There's people there. Just saying. Don't do that. And yeah. So we're gonna have a lot of stuff, but I'm extremely thankful. It's been really nice to just get away. Even like not feeling good, I'm just like, it's nice to have help and know that Timberly's good and taken care of, and I can just veg if I need to. So I'm super excited. If you post one, you gotta put it in the comments so I can go watch it, because you know they're my favorite videos to watch. I say this every year that I'm gonna try to post more, but I am going to try to post more. YouTube is hard, especially in the day and age of TikTok. TikTok is so easy, but I don't like TikTok that much. Like, you blow up for no reason. Like, I have way too many followers on TikTok, which I know probably sounds silly, but I don't do anything. I'm not a TikToker. I just had a few videos go viral, and then you have like 30,000 followers. I'm like, for what? I post on there like once every 4 months, okay? And it's not even like, I don't even put effort into it, whereas YouTube put effort into it, and it's harder because everyone's so quick, first 3 seconds. But we need our attention spans back, okay? So if you have YouTube video suggestions, let me know, because YouTube is what I love, and I could edit all day long. I love it so much. But yeah, 2023 is gonna look a lot different for our family in good ways, I'm hoping. So a lot of changes, a lot of good changes happening. So I'm excited, I'm expectant. That's my word for 2023. So we pick words up for the year, not like New Year's resolutions. And sometimes we'll do like a family word and then singular words. But the Lord just put that on my heart. Expectant. That is my word for 2023. I just want to cry now. You know when you're just like out of nowhere and God just like meets you where you're at? I hate the saying like God showed up, because like he's always here. Like God doesn't have to show up because he's here. Like meeting you where you're at, like, so he just sat down next to me and said, hey, expectant. Okay, I'm expectant for this next year. I don't know why I'm crying. I'm gonna leave now because this is awkward. I hope you guys had a great Christmas, and like I said, tag me in your videos, let me know what videos you want to see. Also, Michael started a food blog. I'm gonna link it in the comments. He always makes the coolest like mixtures of food. So he worked in food for a while. And you know how guys just like eat like manly food, like I don't know, like loaded cheese fries, something like that, which I'll definitely eat that too. But he just comes up with like the coolest variations of food and combinations, and we're gluten-free, we're dairy-free. He's peanut-free. We can't have peanut butter in the house, so we're all peanut-free now. I'm egg free, don't do soy, like all this kind of stuff. And we try to eat everything organic or at least non-GMO. And he's done so good at like making sure we still have the yummy foods. So I pushed him to start a food blog. It's called Michael Doesn't Share Food on Instagram, and we're gonna get the blog running up in a few days. So he's gonna post recipes. We'll probably post like some of our favorite like gluten-free healthy finds at like different grocery stores. So I think it'll be fun, like a fun little outlet for him, because he loves to cook and do all that kind of stuff, which is nice for me. I like to bake, but I don't like to cook. I just don't like to cook. And I'm really bad. Like, if he's not there to make food, I just don't eat, which I know is really unhealthy. I know, and I already have an unhealthy relationship with food, so I'm working on that. But he's really good. He'll, like, prep my food out for me. So if I'm home when he's at work and I'm working from home, he has everything ready, so I just have to heat it up. So I know it makes me sound like a child, but it's okay. But yeah, so I said I wasn't gonna make this long, and now here I am talking about cheese fries and crying. So I hope you guys have a very Merry Christmas. Let me know video ideas below. Maybe we'll do a cooking video with Michael. Also, I got Michael this book. We were on the way home from, I said I was gonna leave, and I'm like, actually, so I got Michael this book. We were on the way home from something, and it was like late, and you know, on like the Christian radios, where it was a Friday night, so like after 8 o'clock or something, like not a podcast but a talk show thing comes on, I don't know, Focus on the Family, that's what was on, and it was with Gary Thomas, and we were listening to it, and we were like, dang, this is good, like everything he was saying was really good, and talked about this book. Michael's like, oh, I want to read that. And so we do, for Christmas, we do something you want, something you need, something to do, something to read. And this was Michael's something to read. I didn't get something to read because someone had just got me a book. So I was like, Michael, I gotta finish the first book I'm on. but it's Married Sex. It's a Christian couple's guide to reimagining your love life. He started reading it this morning. He said it's really good. I was flipping through. I was like, hey, I'm going to read that after you. So I don't know why this is not talked about in the church a lot of times, but married people have sex. It's what you're supposed to do. Christians, you have sex. It's what you're supposed to do. So this is, from what I looked at, really good, and Michael's already really enjoying it. So I'm gonna read it. Oh, one of my goals for 2023 is to read one book a month, which if you know me, I don't really read. I read if I have to, or there's been a few books that I like, but I don't read a lot. And when I find a book I like, I read it really fast. So I'm just trying to, not like, you know, everyone's like new year, new me, but I find the new year very refreshing. I find like the start of a month refreshing, the start of a week refreshing. So people think it's silly, but like, why not? And also, I decided I'm doing a 10K in April. Who am I, right? Some days I can't get out of bed, but now I'm gonna go run 6 miles. Why not? I'm expectant of what the Lord's going to do in and through me. So we've got our training plan mapped out. My sister's doing it. Michael might do it. I think my aunt's gonna do it. We're doing the Cooper River Bridge run in Charleston. So I'm excited for that. Maybe I'll vlog my 6 miles. So a lot of good stuff. A lot of stuff going on. Doctors trying to get healthy for our whole family. So yeah, expect it. That is how we're entering 2023. And let me know your word for the year as well. And I hope you guys have had a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year. Bye. I wanna have him beside me like, oh, on the 25th.